Dear friends, in this video we are going to see 10th and 100th class 5 maths question and answer with full explanation. Question number 1. What was the length of the smallest pencil you have used? How long is this pencil? First you guess dash centimeter. Then measure it using a scale. How good is your guess? We can see that Anju used a lens to make it look bigger. Now you see the length of the pencil, that it is kept from 0 to in between 3 and 4. That means 3.6. You can count the number of lines in between 3 and 4 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 5, so is 6. So 3.6 centimeter. So the smallest pencil that I had used was about 1 centimeter long. I think the given pencil here, the whatever the pencil is given, the length of the pencil is more than 3 centimeter. That is my guess. When I measure it with the help of a scale, here is the scale. Using the scale, the length of the pencil comes out of 3.6 centimeter exactly. So my guess was correct. Question number 2. What does 0.9 centimeter mean? It is the same as dash millimeter. We can also say this is 9/10 of a centimeter. Right? So 30.5 centimeter is same as dash centimeter and dash millimeter. It is 30 centimeter and 5 millimeter. About how many of the big frogs will fit on the 1 centimeter scale? Another question. If they fit in a straight line, about how many of the smallest frogs will cover 1 meter long? So first question we will see in this. What does 0.9 centimeter means? We know that 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. So 0.9 centimeter, actually it is 9 millimeter. That is 0.9 centimeter means 9 millimeter. In decimal we can say it is 9/10. 9/10 centimeter, or we can say 0.9 centimeter. So it is the same as 9 millimeter. We can say as in millimeter, we can say 9 millimeter, because we know that 1 centimeter is 10 millimeter. So 30.5 centimeter is same as 30 centimeter and 5 millimeter. Now 30.5 centimeter can be written as 30 centimeter and 5 millimeter. Next, coming to next sum, we know that 1 meter 100 centimeter, we studied in 4th standard. The length of the biggest frog, it is given 30.5 centimeter. That is, thus a maximum of 3 big frogs can fit on 1 meter scale. Length of each small frog is 0.9 centimeter only. Thus a maximum of 111 small frogs can be sit in a straight line cover 1 meter. In 1 meter we can make 111 frogs can be sit in a straight line. Question number 3. Length of the nail is given in the drawing is dash 2 centimeter and dash millimeter, or 2. dash centimeter. The length of the nail, it is you can find that it is 2 centimeter and 9 millimeter. You can count it from here. Here you can find 1 full centimeter, here you can find 1 centimeter, then 2 centimeter, then it is not coming 9 centimeter. It is before that it is the line it touches. So it is 2.9 centimeter. It is 2.9 centimeter. So the length of the nail, is 2.9 centimeter. Exactly 2.9 centimeter. Likewise, you can find the length of this lady finger. So we can find the length here. The lady finger is kept it from 1, then it ends by here. So how many centimeter you have to count from 1? 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and small lines are there, 1, 2, 3, 4 lines are there. So 8.4 centimeter. If the length of the lady finger is 8.4 centimeter. Now we can see the length of the lady 8 centimeter and 4 millimeter we can write. We know that 10 millimeter 1 centimeter. So 1 millimeter 1 by 10 centimeter. 4 millimeter means 0.4 centimeter. So 8.4 centimeter we can write. Using the scale on this side, find the difference in length between candle 1 and candle number 3. Now you can find length of the candle 1, length in centimeter and millimeter, length in centimeter. Flame 1, candle 2, flame 2, candle 3, flame 3. Like that we are going to find the length of the candle. First one, candle 1, the length of the candle we will find out. Using the scale, you can find the length of the candle. The length of the candle 2 centimeter and 9 millimeter. That can be written as 2.9 centimeter. Now we will find the flame 1. Flame 1, this length only you have to measure. It is 1 centimeter and 3 millimeter. That is 1.3 centimeter. You can write in centimeter. So 1 centimeter 3 millimeter can be written as 1.3 centimeter. Similarly, we can find the length of the candle number 2. Candle length, using scale you have to measure it. The length is 4 centimeter 9 millimeter, can be written as 4.9 centimeter. Flame 2, we are going to measure only the flame length from here to there. So the length of the flame is 1 centimeter 9 millimeter, that can be written as 1.9 centimeter. Similarly, candle number 3, you can find the length of the candle is 6 centimeter and it can be written as 6.0. The flame of candle number 3, 1 centimeter and 9 millimeter. So 1.9 centimeter, it can be written in centimeter. Question number 5. Guess the length to draw these things. Ask your friends to draw the same line. After you make the drawing, use a scale to measure the length. Whose drawing showed a better guess? An ant of length less than 1 centimeter. Measure your drawing. You draw and measure it. You will get an answer. And ask your friends to measure the same thing. Pencil of length 7 centimeter. Measure your drawing. 7 centimeter length you have to draw a pencil. And ask your friends to draw. A glass 11 centimeter high with water up to 5 centimeter. A glass height is 11 centimeter. This is 11 centimeter and water in this glass is 5 centimeter. You have to draw. Ask your friends to draw the same thing. Curly hair of length 16 centimeter. Curly hair of length 16 centimeter. 16 centimeter. This is the hair length. Ask your friends to draw the same thing. Now, question number 6. Which line is longer? A or B? A or B? Measure each line and write how long it is in centimeter. How good is your guess? Now, first you are going to guess the answer and you have to measure it also. A and B, these two lines are there. Another question, which line is longer? C or D? C is longer or D is longer? Measure and find the answer. I think line B is longer than line A. By seeing you can identify. Our eye, we can guess B is greater than A, longer. So with the help of scale or ruler, we get the measurement of line A. You can find using the scale, you can find the length of A as 4.6 centimeter. It is 4.6 centimeter. The length of line B is, you can say, it is B as 4.6 centimeter. That means both lines are same length. So our guess was incorrect. Actually, the B length is more than A. The length of B, definitely it should be more than A. So our guess was incorrect. I think both C and D are same measurement, our guessing. With the help of ruler, we get measurement 3.2 centimeter for both the line. This one also 3.2 centimeter. This height, I mean, the line C is also 3.2 centimeter. So our guess is correct. Whatever we guess is correct. Question number 7. What is the length of 100 rupee note? Guess. Now measure it using a scale. Now guess the length and width of many other things. Measure and find the difference between your measurement and your guess. 100 rupees note. You have to measure the length of the note and you have to find the width of the note. Take 100 rupees note. You have to find the length. This is the length of the note. This is width of the note. Length and width using scale, you have to measure it. Next one. My guess length of notebook. Here in the last it is given notebook. The length of notebook 25 centimeter. The width of notebook 20 centimeter. Measurement notebook 22. My guess is 25, but when I measure it, the answer it comes 22.3 centimeter. The breadth or the width, it comes 18.3 centimeter. So there is some little difference in our guess and the real measurement. Difference in length between my guess and real measurement. What is the difference? See how to find the difference between 25 minus 22.3, 2.7 centimeter difference. Similarly, the breadth or the width, guess also we can guess. 20 minus 18.3, 1.7 centimeter is the difference between the two measurement. Now, that 100 rupees note, the length is 20 centimeter, the width of the 100 rupees note is 10 centimeter. So this is my guess. But actually when I measure it, it was 15.8 centimeter. The length of the 100 rupee note is 15.8. The width is 7.3 centimeter. 10 rupee note, my guess was 15 centimeter and width was 7 centimeter. But really, it was 13.7 centimeter and 6.3 centimeter. Take 20 rupee note, then 5 rupee note. Then you take one postcard. Postcard length is 12 centimeter. The width is 7 centimeter. But really, when I measure it, 10.5 centimeter. The length and width is 6.75 centimeter. Our math test book, math magic book. My guess was 25 and 20. Width is 20, but really it is 24 centimeter, and width is 18 centimeter. You can measure yourself and find the answer for this question. How many paise does a matchbox cost? Here is the price list is given. How many matchboxes can be got for rupees 250? 2 rupees 50 paise, how many matchboxes can be got or can we buy? How many rupees does the soap cost? What is the cost of the soap? Here you can find the cost of the soap, 8 rupees 75 paise. Arun wanted to buy a soap. He has 5 rupee coin. 2 1 rupee coin and 4 half rupee coin. What write in rupees, what money he will get back. So let us see first question. How many paise does a matchbox cost? We know that the matchbox is 50 paise. It is given 0.50. that means 50 paise in the cost of one matchbox. 1 rupee we know 100 paise. So the cost of matchbox 0.50, that is 50 paise. Cost of matchbox 50 paise. Amount of money to buy matchbox 2 rupees 50 paise. How many matchboxes we can buy for 2 rupees 50 paise? Here we can buy 5 matchboxes can be bought for 2 rupees 50 paise. When you work out, 2 rupees can be written as 2 × 100 paise. 200 paise plus 50, 250 paise. Actually, for 50 paise, we will get 1 matchbox. So 250 divided by 50, you will get 5 matchboxes. The cost of soap, directly you can write the answer 8 rupees 75 paise. Question number 3, the cost of 8 rupees 75 paise. Question number 4, we know that 1 rupee 100 paise. Arun has 5 rupee coin, 2 1 rupee coin, then 4 half rupee coin. So how much he is having? 5 1 rupee coin. So 5 × 100 500 paise, 2 1 rupee coin, 2 × 100 200 paise, then 4 half rupee coin. So 4 × 50 200 paise. So altogether he is having 900 paise. That means 9 rupees. So cost of soap is 8 rupees 75 paise only. So 9 minus 9 rupees minus 8 rupees 75 paise. So in the answer it will come is 25 paise. 25 paise. That is here 900 paise minus 875 paise minus, you will get 25 paise. Can be written as in rupees 0.25. So 0.25 rupees. When you convert into rupee divided by 100, because 100 paise make 1 rupee. And egg cost 2 1/2 rupee. 2 rupees 50 paise. 2 and a half means 2 rupees 50 paise. How much will 1 1/2 dozen? 1 dozen means 12. 12 number is called dozen. So 1 dozen 12 eggs. So 1 1/2 dozen means 12 plus 6, 18 eggs. We have to find the cost of 18 egg. 1 egg is 2 rupees 50 paise. So 2 rupees 50 paise can be written in paise, 250 paise. So 18 multiplied by 250, you will get, if you multiply, you will get 4500 paise. Can be written in rupees. Rupees, when you written in rupees, divided by 100. When you divided by 100, 2020 get, so 45 rupees. So the cost of 1 1/2 dozen, that means 18 egg. The cost of 18 egg x is rupees 45. Total money with Kannan 60 rupees. Cost of 1 1/2 dozen egg 45 rupees as per the sum. Total money left with Kannan 60 minus 45. These two you have to subtract. So rupees 15. Rupees 15. Can be written in its paise multiplied by 100. When you convert rupees into paise multiplied by 100, it will become 1500 paise. Kannan uses the money that is left for purchasing pen. Cost of pen 6 rupees 50 paise, that is actually 650 paise. No, cost of 2 pens, 2 × 650, 1300 paise, that means 13 rupees. So divided by 100, nothing else. Just you divide by 100, you will get 13. So Kannan can buy only 2 pens with the amount of money that was left with him after purchasing egg. Money left with Kannan after purchasing pen. So he will have 2 rupees. Kannan was left with 2 rupees after buying 2 pen. The price of 2 pen is ₹10. The 2 pen cost is 13 rupees. So can she buy 2 pens? She can buy 2 pen. Possible he can buy. Match the following. Half rupee half 50 paise. Rupee half is 50 paise. Rupee 1/10 can be written as 10 paise. That can be written as 10 by 5/100 can be written as, you can say, 5 paise. 3/4 rupees, that is actually 75 paise. 99/100 is equal to 99 paise. 1/4 rupees, that is actually 25 paise. The same we can write in paisa into rupees. 5 paise can be written as in rupees 0.05. How we have to write to 5 divided by 100? 5. 2 place is there, so you have to move 2 place, 0.05. That is the answer. Like that, 25 paise can be written as rupees divided by 100 is equal to 2 place left side and keep the point, 0.25. So small unit to higher unit, you have to divide. Similarly, we can find the answer for other paise, 50 paise. It is in 0.50 rupees. Colorful design. What part of the sheet is colored blue? Blue color is out of how many strips are there color? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10. Out of 10, one strip is colored blue. So, 1 is blue color. We can say that it is 1 by 10. 1 by 10. Okay. Thus, 1 by 10 of the sheet is blue color. Number of green color strips. Green color you can see 1, 2, 3. There are 3 green colors. So, 3 by 10. Out of 10, 3 colors are green. So, 3 by 10 we can say. Number of yellow colors you count out 1, 2. 2 yellow. So, 2 by 10 can be written as 0.2. So, 2 by 10 of the sheet is yellow color. Now, another colorful sheet you can see. Second sheet. It is divided into 100 equal parts. Here, if you count 1, 2, 3, 10. Here also 10, 10 tens are 100 equal parts. So, each strip is divided into 10 equal parts. Here first strip, 10 equal parts, you can find 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like the 10. Here also 10 equal parts, 10 equal parts, totally 100 parts are there. So, here the question is, 1 by 100 part of the sheet is, each box is 1 by 100, yes. This is 1 by 100. This box is also 1 by 100. Each box is 1 by 100 only. How many blue boxes are there? You can see 1 to 10. So, there are 10 boxes in the sheet are blue. 10 boxes in the sheet are blue. Is blue equal 10 by 100 of the sheet? Yes, of course, 10 by 100 of the sheet. Okay. We saw that blue is equal to 1 by 10 of the sheet. When you divide 10 by 100, can be written as 1 by 10. Because 0, 0 you can cut, so 1 by 10 it will get. So 1 by 10 can be written as 0.1 of the sheet. 1 by 10, when you write in decimal, 0.1. So can we say that 10 by 100, 0, 0 you can cut it? Yes, 1 by 10 can be written as 0.1. Yes, we can say, yes. Can we write 10 paise as 0.1 of a rupee? Of course, we can write yes only. How many boxes are red color? Red color, how many are there? Here 10, here were 5. 10 plus 5, 15 boxes are red color. Can be written as 15 by 100. Which part of the sheet it is? 15 by 100. Why we are putting 100? Total number of sheet in this 100. 100 small boxes are there. So, can we write 0.15 of the sheet as? Yes, we can say. Now, 3 by 100 of the sheet is black? Yes, of course, 1, 2, 3. 3 by 10 is, 3 by 100 is black. We can say that 0.03. When 3 by 100, when you divide, moving 2 place left side, so 3 by 100 can be written as, 3 by 100 can be written as 0.03. How many white boxes are there? Okay, here 10 white box, here 5, here 7. So totally we can say 22 white boxes are there. So which part of the sheet is it? Is 22 by 100. 22 by 100 of the sheet is white. Now the school Malappuram has its sports day. The first 5 children in the long jump are Tina 3.50 meter, she jump. Meena 4.05 meter, Rehana 4.50 meter, Anu jumped 3.05 meter, and Amina jumped 3.35 meter. Who is the winner in the long jump? Who is the winner? You see, 4.05 or 4.50? Of course, it's 4.50 is the longest jump. Write the names of the first. So, C will be the Rehana is the first winner. Rehana is the first winner. The first winner is Rehana. Second, who is second? Meena. Meena got 4.05. So, second winner, Meena. Third winner is Tina. Tina, you can see. Third winner is Tina. She is third. A first, a second winner. Tina is the third winner. here we can find out, we know that 100 centimeter 1 meter. So 1 centimeter can be written as 1 by 100 meter. So 1 centimeter is equal to 0.01, keeping the decimal outside two places. 1 by 100, how we can write the decimal, keeping the decimal two places left side. So write the number 1, other place is not there, so put 0, then point, then keep on 0. So in this way you can write 0.01 meter. We can also write it is 0.01 meter, or we can say 1 centimeter also. Thank you.